Good afternoon, everyone. This is 287. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a happy and a blessed Sabbath. Now, today I'm going to do two videos, hopefully in short order. And they're both related one to the other. I may go ahead and do a part one and part two so you can link them together as you watch them. But this is about children's responsibilities to the parents. And this is small children all the way up. Now, I did the video about parents' responsibilities to their children, but said parents also need to understand truly what their children, or at least what some of their children's responsibilities are to them, so they can use this as an aid in helping teach them and discipline them. So with that being said, I'm going to go straight to an example of something that happens far too often, and parents are not positive in illustrating to their children what needs to be illustrated to them. Okay, first, don't ever let your children make a mockery of you in the sight of other adults or the Heavenly Father. And I'm going to use the school example for this. If your child misbehaves in school and you get the phone call, or they misbehave in school and the school dishes out some form of discipline, and then your child comes home and informs you, are you the type of parent who, after the conversation with your child, you take that defensive approach, and then the next day you saddle up and you go up to the school and you present yourself in front of this administration with your child, and you proceed to go off, belittle, ridicule, curse out, whatever, these other adults because of your child's negative behavior? Now, more often than not, whatever the administration said your child did and how they decided to discipline it was appropriate. But so many parents, and a lot of them, the majority, are mothers, because the mothers are handling that business with their children more often than not. So the majority of these mothers are the ones standing up in front of these administrations going off, to use the phrase lightly. What you're doing is you're reinforcing this negative behavior to your child. You're teaching them that it's okay to do whatever it is they're doing. You're teaching them that you will defend them. You're teaching them not to have any respect for other adults. You're teaching them that disrespect and bad behavior is okay. You're reinforcing a lot of negative things that will never benefit your child as they get older. But also what you're teaching them is that they have power over you. They are controlling you. Think about it. If they can say mommy this or mommy that, and you jump to go defend their honor, which isn't there to say the least, then they're learning a whole lot about who they can control and whom they have power over, and they will never respect authority. We have to be very careful when we defend our children, especially our young children, in front of other adults and administrations that we give them to help raise them. That's what you're doing. You're giving your children to these schools and these teachers to help raise them and protect them. And then as soon as your child misbehaves, you don't want them to have any level of quote-unquote parental authority to discipline them. Now, they're not beating your children, I pray, but because they discipline them or chastise them or correct them verbally or what have you, you feel as if they're stepping out of line. But yet, what do you want them to do? You want them to say nothing or do nothing? They have rules and guidelines and things that they need to follow. This is just as a administration. But what you should be doing as a parent is reinforcing that, especially once you talk to them and find out what has transpired. A lot of times, the parents go up to these schools and stuff already in defensive mode. And they've already started down the road of defending their children verbally and with any other antics that come before they really find out what has happened. Because why? One, some of you feel like your child can do no wrong. Some of you feel like your child is a little angel. You do not know what your children or child is doing when you're not around. Everyone else does because they see it. But you don't want them to tell you because there's a box of disbelief back there that these kind of comments go to, and you just can't accept that. So we have to come away from that and open up and be willing to listen and understand that our children are children. None of them are angels. Remember, we're all born into sin. We all have that sin nature in us. So, you know, children have to go through it and learn. We cannot empower our children to be disrespectful to other adults. We can't empower them to have power over us, because they're learning as they watch these interactions, and they start using you as a puppet to defend them at every turn. So we have to be very careful when we do these things, because we're teaching them a whole lot that they will end up having accountability for as they get older. Now, what are some of the drawbacks to being this type of parent? Well, as these kids get older, they become teenagers. And as they become teenagers, they start going into adulthood. And if you've reinforced all these negative ideals and attitudes and behaviors, you're going to end up with daughters, possibly, that are pregnant and doing all sorts of uncontrollable things. You're going to end up with boys doing all sorts of uncontrollable things, maybe end up dead or in jail. You're going to end up with all sorts of chaos brought to your home by your children, because you didn't restrain them and correct them when they were small. All you did was reinforce negative behavior because they were your little angels. You cannot do that. You have to be willing to listen to other people. Everyone is not after your child in a negative sense. Most people are looking out for the best interests of your children. Most people in these school systems and places of such are really there because they love kids, and they're looking out and trying to teach them and raise them, help nurture them to be the best that they can be. So we have to be very careful and open-minded when someone says, your child has done something negative. We have to go, okay, what did they do? And you have to be willing to listen. And you have to be willing to drag your child out and force them to be truthful. See, because a lot of times we just listen to what our children say behind our closed doors, and we just believe it. We believe what they say, and then we react accordingly, because there's a disbelief that our children could be lying to us. They react to their own little feelings. They react to their own selfishness, as well as adults. But when it comes to our children, we don't give adults the benefit of the doubt half the time. So we have to come away from this. We have to come away from validating things that they do that are wrong. Because if we validate it by defending them, we tell them that the things that they do is wrong is okay. We have to teach them that things aren't tolerated, that there are repercussions to things that they do. We have to teach them that adults are an authority to be listened to and respected. Not just you, all adults. There's inherent risk in everything, but the majority of the world, as far as adults, when it comes to our children, like I said, are after their best interests. You have to show them that you are firm and strong in your word, and that when other adults are correct, you're going to be firm and strong in supporting them. Like I said, most of us are looking out for the best interests of your children as well as ours, because we want them to grow up to be productive adults in society. We don't want them to end up going down the wrong road, going down the wrong path. Don't empower your children in negative behavior. It can cost them and you dearly in this world and in the eternal. So, with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful and obedient. This is 2 of 8, 7.